they should be on Zoom by now. It's time to film. Oh, I see Pastor Trish and Mr. Brad coming. There they are. Hi. Hi. Hello. I'm going to be here really soon, too. Oh, I hope so, too. Yuppie.
Hey, guys. Hey.
Yeah, and I'm glad you're all here today because of the fact that we can't all get together, and sometimes that's disappointing, but at least we're all here tonight or today or whenever you might be watching this, and we're together in spirit. So get back, relax, you know, enjoy the conversation, and just let God touch you within your heart.
That's awesome. Let's start with some introductions. Go ahead, Pastor Trish.
Well, I'm Pastor Trish, and I am the Christian education pastor here, and I do anywhere from our nursery all the way up to our adult learning classes.
Hello there. I am Brad. I am Trisha's husband. I am also on the council as the gathering, and I help around the church and on property. You're up, Thompson family.
Okay. I'm Jeff Thompson. I teach in a third, fourth, fifth Sunday school class. I lead the 30-hour famine, and then I help participate in other youth events.
Yeah, I'm Brandy. I help with the prayer partners for the confirmation students, as well as helping out with the 30-hour famine. Derek, what about you?
My name is Derek. I'm a student in the junior high Sunday school class. I'm in the 8th grade confirmation class, and I also participate in the 30-hour famine.
My name is Abby Thompson. I'm in the 3rd through 5th Sunday school class, and I participate in some church events. Your turn, Hoyts.
Awesome. I'm Haley Hoyt, and I serve as the pre-K and kindergarten Cubbies Sunday school teacher.
I'm Murphy Hoyt.
I'm Murphy Hoyt.
You can say hi. I'm Graham.
Graham
and Murphy are Cubbies in our Cubby class. So first up, let's tell them what Thanksgiving is all about. The definition of Thanksgiving is to express gratitude, especially to God, to give thanks, to express our gratitude and show appreciation, to thank, to acknowledge, and to recognize. Today, we are going to share some readings and some of our thoughts on Thanksgiving. Before we have our first reading, Brandy and Jeff, could you share what you're thankful for?
Yeah, sure. Do you want to go first? You want me to?
Go ahead.
Okay. This time of year, I'm super thankful for family. Thanksgiving is definitely one of my absolute favorite holidays. We get to spend time with family, some fellowship time, seeing family from around here and some that's not around here. So it's great to get together. It's great to have that time to remember that all the things we have come through God and we wouldn't have any of these things without Him. So we're just very thankful to give credit to Him and to celebrate time with family.
Yeah, and I'm thankful that we just serve a God who loves us unconditionally and that He shows us grace and shows us favor. I'm very thankful for my family, both within this household and, you know, spread out across the U.S. I'm thankful for my church family and as well as our close friends.
Now we have a reading from Faith member Sandy Perry.
Our reading comes from Psalm 100. Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before Him with joyful songs. Know that the Lord is God. It is He who made us, and we are His. We are His people, the sheep of His pasture. Enter His gates with thanksgiving and His courts with praise. Give thanks to Him and praise His name. For the Lord is good, and His love endures forever. His faithfulness continues through all generations. Here ends the reading.
Abby and Derek, what does that verse mean to you? Can you help me so that I can help Graham and Riker understand?
That verse to me means to be thankful for God and to worship God.
To me, that verse means to enter the church with praise and thank God for everything He's done for us.
Thank you both so much. Does that help, guys? That does help. Thank you so much. Hey, Mr. Brad, what are you thankful for?
I am thankful for my family, my wife and kids, my church family, all the support they give us. And now I'd like to introduce our second reading from the New Testament, We have Kelly Anderson, our interim administrative assistant at Faith.
Thanksgiving blessings to all. Today's reading is 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 16 through 18. Be joyful always, pray continually. Give thanks in all circumstance, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus.
Pastor Judge, what if I don't feel thankful?
Yeah, and sometimes, Riker, we all get into that where we aren't thankful or don't feel like we're being thankful at that point in time. And we have to sometimes have that attitude of gratitude, and when we're not feeling it, sometimes that's hard. But one thing, Riker, that you can do is find a little notebook, and then you can write down when you're having good days, write down those things that make you feel thankful at that point in time. And that will help you when you are feeling that little bit of, you know, not grateful for what God has given us. But what we have to do is we have to form good habits. And good habits is every day getting into your notebook and writing something that might help. And Mom and Dad could probably help you with that. But in the gospel reading that we are going to have by Barb, it's going to talk about someone who is an example of this, Riker. They listened to Jesus sharing God's will is one of the worst scenarios possible. But Barb is going to help us know what that gospel means. And so our parish nurse is going to read the Gospel of Luke 17, 11 through 19.
Happy Thanksgiving, Faith Lutheran Church. I'm here today to share the Gospel of Luke with you. We are in the 17th chapter, verses 11 through 19. Let's read. Now on his way to Jerusalem, Jesus traveled along the border between Samaria and Galilee. And as he was going into a village, 10 men who had leprosy met him. And they stood at a distance, and they called out in a loud voice, "Jesus, Master, have pity on us." But when he saw them, he said, "Go show yourselves to the priests." And as they went, they were cleansed. One of them, when he saw that he was healed, came back praising God in a loud voice. He threw himself at the feet of Jesus and thanked him. And he was a Samaritan. And Jesus asked, "Were not all 10 cleansed? Where are the other 9? Has no one returned to give praise to God except this foreigner?" And then he said, "Rise and go. Your faith has made you well." Here ends our reading from the Gospel of Luke.
Thanks, Barb. Hey, kids, do you remember hearing that story before?
Yeah.
Yeah, good.
Hey, Riker, what are you thankful for?
I'm thankful for my family.
Yeah, that's a good one. What about you, Graham? What are you thankful for?
Say it out loud.
Your mom and dad. Good one.
Ricky, what are you thankful for?
I'm thankful for my family, our health, football.
Football, yes. Awesome. Hey, Abby and Derek, what about you guys? What are you thankful for?
I am thankful for my family and for my church.
I'm thankful for family, friends, my church, and everything I'm privileged to have.
Oh, that's nice.
That's awesome, you guys. Hey, Graham, do you have a question for Pastor Trish? Do you want brother to say it?
Cool. Will you pray for us, Pastor Trish?
Yes, I would love to. Dear Heavenly Father, as we gather here to understand what Thanksgiving means to all of us and to appreciate all you have given to us, you've shared that one and only son that you've had. For that, we are so grateful. With much love, we give thanks. In your holy and precious name, amen.
Amen.
Thank you for the prayer, Pastor Trish. I just realized we haven't heard what you're thankful for.
Well, one of the things that I'm really grateful and thankful for is the Faith family. They were there to support me, and that's how come I have the word and the name pastor, is because they supported me, prayed for me, and did all of those things that I needed at that time. And I'm also thankful for my hubby because, you know, it's hard to be a pastor's spouse. And so I'm thankful that God gave me such a special person. And I'm also thankful for my kids because I feel like, you know, they're just a special gift from God in itself. So those are the things that I'm thankful for.
Thank you for sharing, Pastor. Being able to connect virtually is one of the things I'm most grateful for right now. And I'm also thankful for my family and for our health and for all of the work that everyone is putting in so that people can connect virtually, even though we're staying safe at home, huh? Yeah. Exactly. Just like this Thanksgiving Eve service, we wouldn't have been able to make this possible without each and every one of you that are on the screen and those of you that are tuning in to watch. Thank you all for making this happen. Stay safe, and we will see you soon, even if it's virtual.
Yeah, thank you all for coming. We hope you guys come back. You can come to our website every Sunday and see one of our services at faithlcmc.org. We hope to see you soon.
Bye. Bye.
Blessed be your name when I'm found.